So I got this 2015 MacBook Pro from my wife's uncle telling me the Wi-Fi wouldn't work anymore. At first I was uncertain if this would make up a good video, especially as there's ample of instructions on iFixit.com on how to swap the AirPort adapter. But you convinced me anyway, and as it turned out, the repair was not as easy and straightforward as I had initially thought.
Pay attention, revealing plot twist ahead.
Have you ever fixed an old computer? I did, many times. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. Upon first startup, it's already imminent something's wrong, as we're missing the little Wi-Fi icon on the login screen. Once logged in, it actually does appear in the menu bar, however, none of the nearby Wi-Fi's is detected. Also, when going into the control panel, it looks totally odd, claiming the Wi-Fi is off, and even when trying to enable it, nothing would come from it. Also, removing the Wi-Fi and trying to re-add it would be of no success, as no AirPort adapter would be shown. Having said that, inspecting the system information makes it imminently clear that something's wrong here, as no further hardware information besides the software versions is shown. Also, when looking under the hood with the iOREG utility, shows the absence of the Wi-Fi board. Well, it could be a simple thing, maybe a misconfigured NVRAM or PRAM, or maybe the system's management controller doing something weird here, so I'm going with a reset for both first, though that didn't make any difference. So it's well possible that the AirPort adapter is broken, hence I'm opening up this machine to swap it out, as I'm having a functioning one at hand. The Wi-Fi adapter is located just beside the fan. Just remember to be very gentle when unconnecting the antennas in order to not make any damage. Then remove the adapter and plug in the new one. Be careful again, as the adapter has a sticky pad underneath it, so you need to lift it up in an angle in order to remove it. Again, be gentle when reconnecting the antennas. But what a downer seeing it still not working after the next reboot.
May I comment on that?
The thing is, it's very unlikely to be the antennas. And if it's not the Wi-Fi adapter, then it could be the logic board. But what somewhat speaks against it is that the machine seems to work just fine otherwise. And while it's only a wild guess, I wanted to install a benchmark program in order to see if I'll end up with any crashes, which could be a sign for a defective logic board. I wouldn't get thus far though, as already when plugging in the USB key I noticed it wouldn't be detected. At first I thought my key is broken, so I then took another one with the same effect. Interestingly enough, that only happened when plugging into the right hand side. Now, that's exactly the same side where the AirPort adapter is located. Could it be? But one thing after another. The 2015 13-inch MacBook Pro has a main logic board plus different add-on boards, like on the right-hand side this I/O board, where not only the AirPort adapter is located, but also the card reader, another USB port and the HDMI port. Going with the observation of the right-hand side ports including the Wi-Fi not working, that leaves me with three options. Firstly, a logic board defect. Secondly, a defect on the I/O board. Thirdly, as simple as that, maybe an issue with the bridge connector between the two. Maybe it became loose. So I was removing the bridge connector, which then revealed this.
Why is the upper pin row bent down?
That's a very good question, but it already explains everything. So I was asking back and learned that my wife's uncle had swapped the battery of that unit himself. And so it's obvious, when he reassembled it, he squished the connector. Well, maybe I can fix it without swapping everything out. I wouldn't have a spare logic board anyway. I'm using a knife to bend the pins back upwards, gentle and slowly, as I don't want to make any bigger damage. Eventually, it all looks okay again, so I'll be reconnecting the flatband cable again.
Now comes the moment of truth.
And here we are, and as we can see right away, the Wi-Fi icon now is appearing on the login screen. But not only that, also the Wi-Fi detection works again, and so does the USB port. So in the end, what began with a supposed to be simple repair ended with yet another actually simple fix on something entirely different. Would you have guessed it? Let me know in the comments below. Anyways, I revived yet another machine, which I'll be now turning back to its owner. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again next Sunday.